All right, so make the cut importing. So right here, you basically have your importing hub buttons right here. It's your importing toolbar. Everything that make the cut can import can be all be done right here via this toolbar. Now, of course, there are keyboard shortcuts to accomplish the same tasks. Now, if you're wanting to know what those keyboard shortcuts are, you can actually hover your mouse button over the buttons and you'll see a little tooltip pop up letting you know what the keyboard shortcut is. Okay, so the basic concept of the gallery is it's an online storage bank where the users have generated, you know, SVGs and make the cut files that they would like to share with the online community. Now, at the time of this video, there's over 6,000 items that have been donated by kind MTC users. Now, internet connection is needed in order to view the gallery, and it's a free service to those that actually own make the cut. So there's no additional fees. It's just one of the built-in features within make the cut software. All right, in order to access the gallery, all you have to do is simply click this button right up here that looks like a bunch of little grid squares. And from there, a little pop-up window will appear. Now, once that window pops up, you'll have several search and filter options available to you. Now, just to show you how much stuff is actually in there, I'm just going to go ahead and leave the search box blank. And then down here, I'm going to go ahead and display 30 previews per page. And I'm just going to go ahead and click the search button. Now, by leaving this search button blank, this will bring up everything that is currently in the gallery that users have donated. Now, as you can see, there's a lot of pages here that you have to go through, which is why you have to refine your search in order to search what you want to look for. You know, who wants to look through 600 pages? But while we're here, something to note is if you actually want to see what has recently been added to the gallery in the past few days, all you have to do is click that very last page and you will see what is available that has just recently been uploaded. Okay, so let's go back. I'm going to go ahead and refine our search because I'm on a mission and I really need a 3D box for a project that I'm trying to complete. So in the search area, I'm going to go ahead and type the word box, and I'm going to go ahead and go down here and click the descending button because I want to see what's new out there. You know, I want the new 3D box. But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and hit the submit button. Right, so I chose this example because it gives me a few talking points. Now, when a user uploads their item, they're free to tag their uploads with whatever descriptive keywords that they see fit. Now, these key tags are there so that others can find it when they do these gallery searches like we are doing. So this first one that came up is because it was named Treasure Box, not because it was an actual box. Something else to note is that you'll see a difference in these two previews. Now, one has a mat behind the image and the other one does not. Now, whenever you see a mat in the preview window, that means that that user has uploaded this project file as an MTC project. And when you download it, it will be in an MTC format. Now, while this preview in the left here, the treasure box, does not have a virtual mat in there, that means that user actually uploaded this as an SVG file. Now, either way, MTC can actually read these, but you'll see here in a couple seconds what one of the main differences is. Okay, so back to the task at hand. All right, I'm looking for that 3D box set so I can cut it out. And this one right here looks pretty good to me. Let's go ahead and take a closer look at this because this little preview window is kind of small. And all you have to do is just click on the image and you'll see that the image will expand and you'll get a larger preview of that. Okay, so I think I'll take this. Now, in order to open it and to make the cut, I'm going to have to go ahead and click this download button. And since that it's in an MTC file, because, you know, we see the mat in the background, it will prompt us for saving. Now, I'm going to go ahead and save it into my Make the Cut download folder here, and I'm just going to go ahead and give it a basic generic name. Now, once you do that, it will automatically open up that Make the Cut project file into the Make the Cut window. Okay, so the next thing that I want to show you what happens is when we actually download an SVG. So I'm going to go ahead and scroll all the way back up here to the top where we saw the treasure box, because we know that it is an SVG because there's no virtual mat behind it. And I'm going to start off with a blank canvas in the background. And right here where that red line is, that red caret, that is where our SVG that we download from the gallery is going to be placed. So as you can see, there's no save dialog. So keep that in mind when you're downloading the SVGs, because they're not actually saved to your computer. They're placed on your virtual mat, and you're going to have to manually save that in order to put it on your hard drive. Okay, so one more thing before we're all done with this segment. Say, for example, that I have a friend and I know their user ID, or, for example, say that you really like this 3D cookie box design and you want to take a look to see if this user has donated anything else that you may like. Well, you can simply go ahead and go to the back, go to the main gallery page here, and we're going to go ahead and clear everything out. So clear the search box, and right down here where it says search ID, that's where we can use the drop-down menu, and we can find the user. So that user for that cookie was 5957. So as you can see that this user only has donated two files to the gallery, and we're probably not going to find anything else, but it just goes to show you that you can search by user ID to see what else that user has donated. And as you can see that within this community, that one person has donated over 1,000 files. So the community is great for giving, and it's also a good resource for you in order to not recreating the wheel. So this about wraps up the gallery importing, and I'll see you next lesson.